Let us talk about meter bridge now. Meter bridge or slide wire bridge. It is an application of Wheatstone bridge. Why this is termed as meter bridge? Because there is 1 meter long wire, and 1 meter long wire is here, AB. Right? These are metallic strips. There is a gap, left hand gap, and one gap in the right hand side. This is I-shaped strip and another L-shaped. So there are 2 L-shaped strips and 1 I-shaped strip. This is meter scale which is placed and pasted near the wire, so you can measure the length whenever you need to measure it. Where do we use meter bridge? Meter bridge is a very sensitive device and it is used for measuring so many things. Like you can measure the value of unknown resistance. You can find resistivity of material of wire. You can also verify series and parallel combination of resistors by using this device. It is totally based on principle of Wheatstone bridge, and that is to balanced Wheatstone. That is IG is equal to 0. So if you say what is principle of Wheatstone bridge, principle balanced Wheatstone bridge. That is, when IG is 0, ratio of the resistors are equal. Now question arises, so many things are there. The wire which is used here, 1 meter long wire, it is made of constantan or manganin. These are slightly thick metallic conducting strips. These strips are kept thick because these strips are kept thick so that resistance offered by these strips will be less. This question is also very frequently asked in the board exam. Why these metallic strips are made thick? So answer is to reduce the resistance, effective resistance of the circuit. So no wastage of current in these arms. Let's see how do we use it. Number one, to find unknown resistance. Unknown resistance. To determine unknown resistance. This experiment you will do in the lab also. How you have to make connection? Take a metallic wire whose resistance is not known or unknown, put it here in the left hand gap, say it is X. A known resistance value box called resistance box, you can place it here in the right hand gap. One terminal is left. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 terminals. So we have so far used only 4. From this middle terminal, connect galvanometer and another terminal of galvanometer with jockey. Now see how to determine resistance and connect EMF source here. Cell, if you want to place key K place, or rheostat. However, you need to maintain current constant, rheostat will help you out. Now how to proceed with the steps? Number one, first check the circuit. How do you check the circuit? Bring jockey in contact with the wire near point A. Then near point if you observe that deflection in galvanometer, deflect zero is at center, so the needle deflects left and right. So if when you see the deflection in needle of galvanometer is in opposite direction, suppose when you bring jockey near point A and bring in contact with the point A, it deflects towards left. So while you will bring it in contact with B, it should deflect towards right. If it happens after making connection, your connections are correct. So you can proceed with the experiment. What you have to do then, plug out one resistance from the resistance box. First thing is check the circuit. How do you check circuit? Near point A, needle deflects one side, say left. Then near point B, it should deflect towards right. Second, plug out or take out 1 ohm resistance from resistance box. And find null point. What is null point? It is a point where deflection in galvanometer is zero. So what you will do? You will bring in contact near point A, it is left. Near point B, it is right. Keep on shrinking your length. At certain point in between, this point is Y, where deflection in galvanometer becomes zero. Measure this length, A to Y. How do you measure length? Meter scale is placed. I suppose find null point. Third, measure the length of wire. Wire from A to null point Y, let it be L. Then remaining distance is 100 minus L. Now once you have obtained null point in galvanometer or deflection in galvanometer becomes zero, Wheatstone bridge balance, Wheatstone bridge conditions are satisfied. So you can, there are four resistances, length can be taken one resistance, 100 minus length of the wire can be taken another resistance. So you can write X over R is equal to L over 100 minus L. This implies X is equal to L 100 minus L into R. Now you know each and every value in the right hand side, so there is no hassle. Put up the value and get the value of X. To proceed more readings, what you do? Now plug out or take out 2 ohm resistance from the resistance box. Obtain null point again, you will get different length. Again find out. Likewise you can go 3, 4, 5 for 4, 5 readings. For every next reading you have to take out different resistance from the resistance box and then follow all these steps, calculate the value of X, right? So, and finally you will get 4 to 5 values of X, true? Then take an average, you will get unknown value of unknown resistance by using meter bridge. Now if I say how to determine resistivity of the material of a wire. I'm not rubbing these cases, steps, because these steps are followed in the second experiment also, to determine resistivity of material of wire. So unknown resistance is the main experiment of the meter bridge. Suppose you have proceed till here, you find unknown resistance. Once you have obtained unknown resistance, you have to do two steps more. Number one, what can you do? Two steps more. Listen carefully. Remove this unknown resistance from the left hand gap. Stretch it and measure its length. So what you have to do next step? Remove resistance and measure length. Measure its length. And other thing which you have to measure is radius. See here, radius using screw gauge. This experiment you have done in class 11. So I say let length you have measured is L and radius is R. Then use this formula, rho is equal to R pi R square over L. You will get the value of resistivity. However, for a given temperature, resistivity is constant, right? So you will find the resistivity of a specific material in the constant tables also. So once you have calculated the value of resistivity, you can check your result going there, where in the tables, constant tables, and find it out how close you are with the result. That will justify your experiment also. Similarly, you can do two more experiments. Number one, you can verify series combination. How to verify series combination? Principle remains same, device is same, and steps to measure unknown resistance is same. Third experiment is to verify law of series combination. Series combination. What you will do? Like this, here you connect, take two pieces of the wire. Take two pieces of wire. Connect first X1. Follow the steps. Follow steps of unknown resistance. And calculate the value of X, say it is X1. Now remove this X1 and connect in place of second wire X2. Again follow the steps of unknown resistance and calculate value of X2. Third step. Now connect X1 and X2 in series in the left hand gap. So how do you connect in series? One end of the wire you can connect here, X1, another is left, twist it and join with X2, and other end of the wire you connect here. So when you connect X1 and X2 series and follow the steps of unknown resistance again, this will give you value of X1 plus X2. Left hand gap, and follow the steps of unknown resistance. Now you will get X is equal to X1 plus X2. That is series combined resistance of the series combination. You will get this value. You know the individual value of X1. You know the individual value of X2. So verify, use series combination formula. What is that? R equivalent is equal to X1 plus X2. Now you might say that formulas are same, then result will be same. But this formula, here I am telling you that when you are joining X1 and X2 and follow the steps of unknown resistance, ab wo aapko combined resistance ki value dega jab bhi aap nikaloge average. तो यहाँ पर इंडिविजुअल आपको इसीलिए कैलकुलेट कराई थी. अब आप यहाँ पे रख के देख लो कि R इक्विवेलेंट इसके बराबर आ रहा है या नहीं. इफ बोथ आर सेम देन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन इज वेरीफाइड और देयर कैन बी अ माइनर डिफरेंस लिटिल बिट. सिमिलरली यू कैन आल्सो वेरीफाई एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 4. आई एम नॉट रबिंग एवरीथिंग. Parallel combination. Because in parallel combination also you have to follow the same steps. Connect X1 in the left hand gap first. Follow the steps of unknown resistance. Calculate value of X1. Then X2. Similarly. Now connect. Third step will change. Now you connect X1 and X2 in parallel. So you have to be careful about the connection also. In parallel combination, what you do? Take one end of X1 and one end of X2. Both you connect it here. X1 here and another X2. Is also here. Right? Similarly, when you face steps of unknown resistance again, you will get combined value X. That will be the net value of X1 and X2 in parallel. So you know the value what when you are connecting X1 and X2, what is the value of resistance. So use your parallel combination formula. 1 over R equivalent is equal to 1 over X1 plus 1 over X2. R equivalent is equal to X1, X2. X1 plus X2. Check whether X should be equal to R equivalent or nearly equal to R equivalent, because there can be some experimental errors also in the experiment. That's how meter bridge you can use. And meter bridge is strictly working, I repeat again, on balanced Wheatstone bridge. So I taught you 4 experiments which you will do in the laboratory also. Usage of the meter bridge. And meter bridge, in case of the meter bridge, whenever you obtain null point, we always prefer that null point must be somewhere in the middle. Total length of the wire is 100 cm, so the null point must appear somewhere around 50 cm. Because when you obtain null point nearly at midpoint, the meter bridge works highly sensitive. And right? So few conceptual questions I told you. Number one, the wire of meter bridge is made up of constantan and manganin. Reason we have already discussed property of constantan and manganin previously. Strips are taken as thick to reduce the effective resistance so that consumption of current in other parts can be reduced significantly. Null point method is a highly sensitive method because here consumption of current or electrical energy by other parts is minimized. So, and 4 resistances experiments I told you. Number one, how to find a known resistance, which is basically a mean experiment. If you know how to calculate known resistance, you can calculate resistivity of the material of wire by calculating 2 additional things, length and radius using screw gauge, and the series and parallel combination you can verify by using meter bridge.